Today, the American GI Forum held its annual Memorial Day ceremony. This solemn event honors those military servicemen and women who gave their lives for freedom.
We took today to recognize our fallen heroes, to recite the names of those who have gone before us, who've paid the ultimate sacrifice for our country and our freedom.
Elias Rangel, Abel Ramirez, Jose C.
In today's ceremony, over 100 names were mentioned along with seven combat veterans who were deported after serving their tours of duty.
You can be a green card holder and still serve in our military. Some of these veterans who served honorably were discharged and got into some trouble and wound up being deported. And they did not have any access to medical facilities while they were deported, and they eventually passed away. And it was only then that they were able to come home to their family.
On a recent visit to Ciudad Juarez, Art Leal visited the new veteran support house where many deported veterans are able to get help.
And this is a support house where veterans can live. These veterans don't have family in Mexico, so their only family are other deported veterans. So this support house is there for them to give them access to room and board and food.
In this generation of young students, it appears that they are not taught the importance of what a great unselfish sacrifice military servicemen and women do for our freedom.
This is very important because they somewhere, somehow, they've had a relative that passed away and was probably never acknowledged. Have never known that they had a family member that was in the service or had passed away.
We need to remember that we're just Americans. That's it, plain and simple, we're Americans.
It's a slap that people who take our freedoms for granted, who commit crimes, who come and steal a flag from the cemetery, like what happened this morning.
Reporting for DRB Media Communications, Danny Barrera.